Hello and welcome to my channel, the Metaverse Pirate, and I made part 4 of my program called Space Atlas VR, because that program is so big and it's free. You can download it on the Meta Store. You can see it in the link below this video, and it's in English, of course, and it's free. And as you can see, they're making new thingies coming soon. Coming soon, the Voyager 2, the Pioneer 10, to make missions, close missions, because the planet stuff is grating to go. You can see it or you can go. Let's see. Click. There is our sun. And then it's pointing to there. Then you can go to the sun. So let's do the tour of the solar system view. Standard info panel. There's the explanation. Visit sun. Yes, loading. One moment. There is our sun. Take the thingy. And there you can see suns, but no sunspots. So the sun has also a north pole and a south pole. Sun is very hot. It's okay. Something is happening, but I don't know. So this start our tour. Let's look behind me. See the void of space. So our sun. It's a fusion, so two hydrogen atoms come together and form helium, and that's how the sun gets its power, by nuclear fusion of elements. It cannot land on the sun. Missions coming soon. Let's go to the next planet. It's the tour of the planets. Mercury. They call it Mercury after the Greek god. So I will take the planet of Mercury. And the planet of Mercury has an iron core and a magnetic field. It's the same size like our moon, and it has a lot of craters, no atmosphere, no water, no life. And it's scorching hot, and it's locked in orbit, which means that always the same face is facing the sun and the other side is always in the cold. So you can read it here in the Mercury info. Internal structure. Let's see how it's made. See, nickel core, silicate, mantle, magnesium crust, and atmosphere. It's 0.2 atmosphere. It has absolutely no atmosphere. Let's see other thingies. One moment, Mercury. You cannot land. Missions coming soon. Close this thingy. So I'm doing the tour of the planet. Next planet. Venus, the goddess of love. One moment, please. Yes, there's Venus. Take Venus. So the atmospheric pressure on Venus is about 30 to 40 bars, 40 times bigger than our own atmosphere on Earth. It's scorching hot, and the temperature is about 400 degrees Celsius. That's the melting point of lead, so everything becomes liquid. And the Russians did about 40 years ago. They landed their spacecrafts over there, and they only lasted it for 20 minutes because the clouds are made of sulfur dioxide. It's the most toxic planet ever. Land on Venus. Yes, I can land on Venus. This is a first for me. I never done that before. Okay, I'm in my space helmet. The HUD can switch on and on. Venus panel. Yes. So internal structure again. One moment, open. Let's see what it's made of. Iron core, rocky mantle, basalt crust, and atmosphere. Here's the close it. So we are on the surface of Venus, and it's a thick mist, and it's very hazy, so no life possible on this planet. Venus panel. Close it. Leave Venus surface because it's very hot here. The temperature is 464 degrees Celsius. The pressure is here 90 atmospheres. The gravity is about 19.1%, and this carbon dioxide and some nitrogen. So leave this hellhole. It's not Brussels, Belgium. Okay. Loading. Next planet, visit the planet Earth. Already did that in the first three episodes, but let's do it again. Surface features. Okay, pictures like that. One moment. I'm standing outside of my circle, so I can watch the things like that. Well, we all know about that planet. That's amazing. That is the Pacific Ocean. And the Pacific Ocean is all water. It's all water. Over there you see New Zealand and Australia, but upside down. A moment, I will put it like that. So you can see that the Pacific Ocean is a very big ocean. Let's go to the next planet, Mars. It's a quick tour of the planetary system. Mars info. The moons open. Phoebus. It's not actually a moon, it's an asteroid catched by the gravity of only 22 kilometers. And then the other moon, Deimos. Phobos means fear and anxiety or something like that. A very small, regularly shaped moons with unusual orbits and compositions. So they're not actually... let's watch the surface. Oh yes, on the polar cap there's actually ice, but it's carbon dioxide. It's frozen carbon dioxide. And in some caves they discovered some water. Mars info. Okay, let's land on Mars. So I'm doing the tour of the planetary system. There you can see that little thingy over there, because there's actually an atmosphere on Mars, but very thin. So Mars rover panel. See at the panel. Perseverance. Path, I can see the current position, 3D model, change mission, Ingenuity, and it's actually a drone. Okay. Okay, let's go to our next planet, and it's called Jupiter. And Jupiter is not a solid planet, it's a gaseous planet. So let's go to the Jupiter info. Let's see the structure of Jupiter. The core is metallic gas and water, methane and ammonia. So it's more a gas planet. And it is 20,000 times bigger than the planet Earth, so in volume. So let's go to the Jupiter info. Let's see. Jupiter info. One moment. Oh, there's not much to see here. I want to see the moons. Oh, yes. I have to set the time speed. 1 second per virtual second. So I have to make it bigger. Set time speed. One moment. Set time speed. So 1 hour per virtual seconds and then start. Okay, here we go. Okay, and now you can see the... One moment, I have to click. No, come on. I said come on. Oh yes, ah, now it's working. You can see how the planets are. Well, it's a mini planetary system. There are moons, but they are considered planets around a failed sun, to be technical. So it's a very Tony Stark thingy. So, and the first one to see the moons of Jupiter was Galileo Galilei, the inventor of the telescope. Well, inventor is a big word because he stole it from a Dutchman, Christian Huygens, and he stole that thingy from him. I can make it bigger like that. So the Voyagers did visit in 85. So the Voyagers did a lot of discoveries. Let's go to our next planet, Saturn. Loading, yes. Let's do the Saturn land on the moons, yes. Take Enceladus, because I already done Titan in episode 1. This is new for me, Enceladus. Oh, yes. Oh, this is a beautiful view. This is a view from, it's an icy planet. And it has geysers, so the tidal waves of Saturn are pulling it apart, and it must be a wonderful thing to visit. So I can put on the HUD on and off, and sell it this panel. Oh dear, internal structure, I can see what it's made of. Supposed rocky core, H2 ocean. Supposed, and there's perhaps life on that planet, and solid water. It's a watery planet, so there's a possibility of life over there. Change it. Surface features. We don't know much about this moon of Saturn. Close. Leaf and Enceladus surface. Already did Titan in episode 1. That was a nitrogen sea. Now I will meet set the time speed. Okay. Oh yes, it's working. There we have Saturn, and every particle of that ring is 1 millimeter. It's ice, mostly ice. And it's a destroyed moon, and Saturn has many moons. So Enceladus, Tethys, and so on. Like that. Well, I will not show you all the moons, but I'll show you the general idea. You can use the camera, but I need buttons. I pressed the button by accident. Sometimes that happens. This program is evolving, and this program is free on the Meta Store. Made in Italy, Europe, not made in America. Back. The planet is pronounced Uranus, not your anus. I know that joke. It's Uranus, not your anus. Typical. Okay, let's do the moons again, set the time speed. One hour per virtual second. Oh, moon. A bit clumsy. One moment. Yes, now it's working. Let's see. Oh yes, now I can see how the moons are turning like that. Miranda. All the moons are turning like that. It has a greenish color, like that. You cannot land on Uranus. Missions are coming. and close it. Next planet. Neptune, our last planet. Visit. One moment, it's loading. It's a very fast loading tempo. And it does not need internet, and that's very handy. You can play it in a place where you don't have the internet. So set the time speed. It's 1 hour per virtual second. And there you see all the moons from Neptune, Larissa. And those moons were discovered by the Voyager, not by a telescope. Then later the Hubble telescope and the Planck telescope and the James Webb telescope. And it's also a gaseous planet and very cold. And then you have Pluto, but Pluto is no longer a planet. It's degraded, downgraded to an asteroid or a dwarf planet. So Pluto. And Pluto was discovered by Percival Lowell. He was a British astronomer. No, he was an American astronomer, but from British descent, if my memory serves me right. Okay. Lovely music over here. So this is the free program Space Atlas VR. You can download it for free. Have fun with it. And if you're an astronomy buff, you will be in heaven. And remember, those makers in Italy are working very hard to do some upgrading. So back to the solar system. Okay, loading. This is, to be honest, the biggest program I ever seen. It's loading. Yes, I'm back in the solar system. So let's do the scale. Can make it 300 times bigger. Oh, I never done that before. Close. Labels. And now I can set the time speed. Yes. Wow. And now I can see everything turning like that. Mercury. I can see the whole system like that, but I cannot take it. No, I cannot take it. So I cannot turn it around like that. Close. View options. Yes. Mission labels. Well, there you have it. This is my last review. The planetary tour of the program Space Atlas VR. We are currently exploring the solar system. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you soon in the Metaverse Pirate for another exciting discovery in the MetaQuest 3. One to beam up, Mr. Scotty. Bye bye.